Hello, people of the internet, and welcome back to my channel. I know I haven't posted in quite a while, but I've been busy. And by busy I mean I've been working and I was sick. And I haven't had time to do anything other than those two things, really. For the past month and a bit. So, YouTube sort of fell by the wayside, but I'm back now. I say I'm back, but I don't know when I'll upload again after this. But I thought, you know, I went out to a bookshop a couple of times. I bought some books. They happened to all fit into a category. So I thought I would do a haul for you. A classic book haul. That's funny, because it's a classic book haul of classic books. All of the books that I bought recently have been classics, mostly because I'm slightly broke and these are the only books I can afford because they're all on special because nobody wants to buy classics apparently. So let's just get right into the haul, starting off with the two books that I bought today. The first one being The Snow Goose by Paul Gallico. I have absolutely no idea what this story is about. But I recognize the name, so I bought it. It's a very small book. It's actually two stories. I was reading the back to try and figure out what it's about. Because the front just says The Moving Classic of Dunkirk. Now, I didn't watch the movie Dunkirk that they made a couple of years ago. So I don't really know what happened there. And I don't know if this book is related to that movie. But I was reading the back to try and figure out what it is, and the back doesn't really tell me very much, other than the fact that this book is apparently about a girl who's an artist and has a hunchback. Apparently? Cool. Moving on to the next book I bought today. The Tennant of Wildfell Hall by Anne Brontë. And I absolutely love the cover of this book so much. I don't know if this is a collector's edition, or not a collector's edition, but like a different... They're all Penguin classics, I think. Oh no, there's Collins classics in my list as well. But I don't know why this cover looks the way it does. I'm not complaining, I absolutely love it, but I know that this is a very specific... I think an edition of this book, because I know that there's a Jane Eyre and a Pride and Prejudice and all of those other kind of classics with these kind of covers as well. But I don't want to read all the popular classic books. I want to read the not so popular classic books. So I thought Anne Brontë, the least known Brontë sister, I'd start with her. Let's move on to the next book. Pollyanna by Eleanor H. Porter. Also a classic. Obviously, you said previously that all of these books are classics. Why are you... Anyway, sometimes I say things strangely. I also picked this book up. I have no idea what Pollyanna is about. When I showed my dad this book after I bought it... He asked me if I've seen the movie Pollyanna, so I know they made a movie of it, but I don't know what this story is about. It just sounds interesting. Pollyanna. It's an interesting name. So, I'm not doing a very good job booktubing right now, because I don't know what any of these books are about. The font, I just realized, is quite small in this book. So that's going to be fun, but at least it's not very long. Next up we have Mrs. Dalloway by Virginia Woolf. I sort of became a bit obsessed with Virginia Woolf at the beginning of this year because I watched the movie Vita and Virginia. And then after that I kind of became a little bit obsessed with her and her life and all of her works. So whenever I find a book of hers, I immediately want to buy it. I would love to have the beautiful covers of, like, the collector's editions that I know they have, and I do plan on buying those one day. But for now, I just want to read the story. I know that Mrs. Dalloway is basically about a woman who decides to host a party, and it follows basically just one whole day the day that she's either planning the party or the day that the party happens. Yes, this is 182 pages long. And yes, it's Virginia Woolf, so I want to read it. Okay, great. Fantastic. The next book I want to talk about is The Blacker the Berry by Wallace Thurman, which is a kind of colorist, or basically a novel about colorism in Harlem in the 1920s. And that's all I'm going to tell you, because that's all I know from reading the back of this book. It sounded interesting. The Blacker the Berry is a nice name for a book. I like the alliteration. Is it alliteration or assonance? I'm not quite sure. Of the bees in the name. I like that kind of thing anyway. So this caught my eye. I don't have anything else to say about this, so let's move on to the next book. The Portable 19th Century African American Woman Writers, which is a collection of stories and essays and I don't really even know what, because I just picked this book up without even knowing what it was about. So I wanted to be introduced to some 19th century African American women writers who I've probably never heard of before, and then I can go out and buy some of their other books or read some of their other works, which will be nice, I think. Next up on my haul, we have The Years by Virginia Woolf. I told you I got obsessed with Virginia Woolf at the beginning of the year, and this page is, oh goodness, oh this is an appendix. I almost had a heart attack when I saw how small this font is, because I thought I was going to have to read a whole book with a font this small. Am I going to? I am going to. This is fantastic. This font is tiny. I don't think you can even see it, but this font is minuscule. And this book is how many pages long? Oh wait, hold on. Let's remove the appendix. Notes. Don't want notes either. We'll read the notes, but I don't want to include them in my page count, because they're not part of the story. Here we go. This book is 318 pages long. But if this font were 12-point font, it would probably have been 500 pages long. Anyway, it's Virginia Woolf. I really want to read Virginia Woolf's books, all of them. I don't know if I'll understand half of what she writes, because it's Virginia Woolf. But it doesn't matter. I'm going to try anyway. And here's a map in the front of this book. A map of central London. I wish I lived in London so I could see how different this is now. That's the last book on my recently bought book list. So recently I've bought 2, 4, 5, 6, 7 classic books, which I'm very happy about. I don't know when I'll be reading any of these, because I'm currently reading 3 other books. And I'm not really getting anywhere with them, because I haven't read in a really long time, because as I said, all I've really had time to do is work and be sick. Thank you for joining me on this escapade through classic books. I will hopefully get to some of these soon. I'm really interested to read The Years now. Hello, my dad is phoning me. Thank you all very much for joining me in this week's video. I don't know when I will post again, because I don't know when I'll have time to make a video again. Hello. I don't know when I'll post another video, but hopefully it will include me reading some of these classic books after I finished reading the 3 other books that I'm busy reading now. But anyway, If you like this video, you can give it a thumbs up. If you'd like to see more book-related videos from me in the future, you can subscribe, and you can go watch the other book-related videos I've done so far. I'll leave a link to the playlist that I made up here. And other than that, I don't have anything more to tell you, so I will see you all in my next video, which I don't know when that will be, but I will see you there regardless. Thank you very much, and good night!